Hey guys, I wanted to share with you guys the very first perfume that I ever got. It's called Sweet Honesty by Avon, and it was gifted to me for my 11th birthday by my best friend at the time. I don't know if her mom was an Avon lady, but I was so pleasantly surprised to receive this gift at the age of 11. It felt so luxurious to receive a bottle of perfume, and I ran out of that bottle a long time ago, but for nostalgia purposes, I decided to go on the Avon website and buy me another bottle. It looks like this. This is the modern version of the bottle. The bottle that my friend gifted me looked different, and I was able to find a version of it on eBay. So this is what the bottle that my friend gifted me looked like. It looks very dainty and cutesy. And this fragrance, it's been around since 1973. So it's a well-known fragrance. And according to Fragrantica, it seems like a lot of people associate this fragrance with their youth or like their grandma. And I feel like this is a very nostalgic perfume for a lot of people, including me, because this reminds me of my best friend at the time. And as for the scent, it's very beautiful. It's like a light, airy, powdery floral scent. This fragrance also contains aldehydes, which makes it very special. I feel like not a lot of popular fragrances these days contain aldehydes. And so in that sense, it does smell a little bit old school, and a lot of people on Fragrantica seem to agree, but when I received this fragrance as a little girl, I had zero reference for how perfumes are supposed to smell. So to me, this fragrance just smelled very dainty and beautiful, like something a ballerina would wear. Now I want to go over the notes with you guys. In the opening, we have Lily of the Valley, Sicilian Lemon, and Aldehydes. And all of that makes for a very sharp, green, soapy, and powdery opening. And in the middle notes, we have hyacinth and rose. And hyacinth is supposed to be like a very soapy, green, multifaceted note, which adds to the soapiness in the opening. And in the base, we have cedar, vanilla, musk, and honey. The honey and the vanilla in the base notes adds just a touch of sweetness that's the perfect amount, and it beautifully balances out the opening and middle notes. And a lot of people say that this fragrance smells a lot like Johnson's baby lotion, which I would agree, but it's like a very pretty, feminine, and delicate baby lotion. So a lot of people say that this fragrance has been reformulated a number of times. I've smelled these two fragrances side by side, and I feel like they smell pretty much the same. This one might smell a little bit on the spicier side for some reason, but this bottle is from the 90s, so it's possible that the scent has been a little bit compromised. So it's really hard to say, but I feel like overall, these fragrances are pretty much the same. I find this fragrance very alluring in an innocent way, and it's intoxicating in a subtle yet very powerful way. I don't know if that makes any sense, but this fragrance will always hold a special place in my heart because it does remind me of my best friend at the time. I lost touch with her. We kind of drifted apart in high school, which makes me really sad. But let me know in the comments below if you're familiar with this fragrance. Maybe it's been sitting on your vanity for decades. And I hope you enjoyed this video today, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.